Daki, who was originally known as Ume and named after an illness, was a gifted beauty that left people in awe. She was born into the entertainment district in the poorest level, her mother having been a prostitute there and her father unnamed. Ume's mother died of the illness she was named after, what is likely syphilis, when Ume was a young child. Now, Ume's beauty not only granted her many opportunities, but also meant her brother felt it necessary to protect her from others. And her brother Gyutaro, for as much as he loved and cherished his sister Ume, was not blessed with the same physical appeal. For that reason, he chose to dote on her, and Ume took that for granted. To follow their mother's passing, Gyutaro raised Ume. He taught her to take what was hers before others could use her, believing in her beauty above all else. He taught her this as they shivered in the cold, freezing and starving, with no money or home to sleep in. She then entered the world of prostitution herself, just as her mother had. One day while Gyutaro was away collecting debts owed, Ume stabbed her customer in the eye with a comb. For that, Ume was tied up and burnt alive, left for dead for her brother to find. While she was in his arms, charred and too burnt to speak, her brother cursed everyone he could, wishing someone would help. Instead, they received more rejection, the same customer having returned to finish him off as well. In her brother's arms, Ume waited for death until they came upon an upper-ranked demon, Doma. Without knowing of her beauty before the burning, Doma felt pity for the siblings and helped them survive by offering the chance to become demons. And with that, Ume and her human past became a distant memory. As a demon, Daki continued to work as an oiran in the entertainment district. It was where she was born and what she knew best. Dating as far back as the Edo period, Daki had been known under numerous names. When women in her house questioned her actions and the growing number of disappearances, Daki would simply add them to the list of missing persons. And it would seem that Daki's appearance-based vanity had a major impact on her dietary desires as a demon, as she only partakes in the consumption of flesh she deems to be beautiful. So much so that she'll even selectively pick at portions of her food. Now, decades later, Daki took on the name Warabihime as her new alias. Hinatsuru, one of Tengen's three Kunoichi wives, was the first to realize Warabihime Oiran was hiding a dark secret. Because of this, she drank poison to leave House Kyogoku. Daki, however, was not so easily fooled. She gave Hinatsuru an obi as a get-well present, but used it to watch Hinatsuru's movements instead. At any moment, if she did anything suspicious, Daki would kill her with the garment. Now, mere days before the Demon Slayers arrived, Warabihime was warned by the Okami of House Kyogoku to try and control her anger, that her treatment of the other girls was causing loss of sanity, life, and staff in general. Because Warabihime made so much money as the Oiran, normally it was overlooked, but now she had taken it too far. When the Okami recalled the stories an elderly woman had shared with her, she began to shake. These stories were of a beautiful Oiran with Hime at the end of her name, who would tilt her head to the side when she was displeased. To avoid suspicion, Daki would change aliases, and one woman had kept track. The Okami realized Warabihime was not human and held a knife behind her back. Now, Warabihime, disappointed in the Okami's refusal to let it go, took her into the skies as her demon self, Daki, and showed her true nature and power. She held her up with her obi wrapped tight until she finally let her fall to her death. As far as she was concerned, there was no point in consuming someone so old and so ugly, her eyes then revealing her to be upper rank 6. Now, just as Daki returned to her place as Oiran, Muzan appeared in her room. He praised Daki for her power as a demon and how many humans she had eaten. Now, Daki immediately bowed to him, showing a respect that she allowed no one else. And even Muzan, who valued fighting prowess over beauty, complimented Daki on her appearance. And Muzan doesn't really compliment others, so this is a major moment. But she is here told that another Hashira will find her, and that Muzan has high expectations for her as he cradled her face gently. And the last thing he told Daki was to destroy a demon wearing a checkerboard obi who had escaped him, just as Tamayo had. And here he is, of course, referring to Nezuko. After some days, Daki becomes suspicious, realizing there was a spy in House Ogimoto. She captures Makio in her obi cloth and tortures her to find out who she is sending letters to. Just as she is about to end Makio for not giving information, Daki hears someone else coming, another busybody. To avoid being found out, Daki escapes with Makio into the ceiling panels just as Inosuke breaks through her room. With Inosuke having lost her, Daki makes makes her way to House Kyogoku, switching to her Oiran persona. There, she goes to a room to find the ugliest member of the house, Zenitsu, and one of the young girls she had tasked with the cleaning of her room, crying. Even with Zenitsu super hearing, he is unable to detect her until she is directly behind him and asking why he is in her quarters. Warabehime Oiran, as she is known to this house, frightens all the girls just by raising her voice slightly. As Daki only values beauty and aesthetic, Zenitsu's presence in her room is off-putting and causes her to lash out verbally towards him and the other girls. As her anger turns physical, almost tearing an ear off the girl meant to clean her room, Zenitsu steps in to protect her. Having his hand sully her skin angers Warabehime so much so that with one strike of her hand, she sent him flying across the room, breaking through one of the paper walls. The master of the establishment begs for Warabehime to forgive the new girl just this once in hopes of de-escalating her anger, bowing before her, just as she had for Muzan. This gesture does manage to appease her, and the fury she had just shown slips away as a gentle smile graces her lips. Back in her room, Daki gets excited over the discovery that the Demon Slayer Corps has arrived at last, and Aishira was not too far behind. Seeking revenge on Zenitsu, Daki waits for the small girls thanking him for his kindness to leave, and then strikes as silently as a snake. Her obi wraps around him and drags him off into the ceiling. Soon after, Daki pays a visit to the beautiful Koinatsu Oiran of Tokito House. That kind Oiran planned to leave and be married, and so before that can happen, Daki finds her to devour her and her beauty alike. But just as she is about to flee with her prey, another Demon Slayer appears, one she knows isn't strong enough to be a Hashira. With Koinatsu wrapped in her obi, she tells Tanjiro that she can only eat someone of Hashira level and not anyone so dirty and old as a regular slayer. As Tanjiro charges at Daki, she strikes him with her obi, the fabric turning hard and strong enough to launch him across the next building. And Daki, despite finding Tanjiro to be ugly, appreciates his eyes and wants to devour them. She follows him to the next building as he cuts Koinatsu Oiran free as he uses aerial attacks to stop her. Facing off against Tanjiro, Daki hears loud sounds close to House Ogimoto, not realizing the Hashira Tengen is nearby. Wanting to know who else is coming, Daki questions Tanjiro, even offering to spare his life for his prowess in fighting. When he refuses to give information, Daki decides to kill him, but Tanjiro changes to his Hinokami Kagura style of fighting and surprises her by cutting through her obi fabric. Without knowing the breathing technique, Daki can tell by sound that the fighting style has changed. Before Tanjiro can finish Daki off, she moves even faster and hits him away with her obi. Using the different sections to speed back to where he was thrown, Daki attacks more fiercely, her obi swirling and stabbing at him like a blade. Daki laughs at his clear struggle to overpower her, pointing out that ugly people cannot accomplish anything. Meanwhile, Inosuke had discovered Daki's larder, but only a fraction of her body is present there. This small part is not enough to fight as her main body's occupied, so she must consume some of the prey she has strung up in her obi to fend Inosuke off. Her obi proves to be too rubbery and thick to be cut by his swords though. When Daki's alternate body is about to eat some of the girls, Tengen's wives arrive and help Inosuke fight. Not only them, but Zenitsu, who is still asleep, joins the fight as well. And to make matters worse, Tengen breaks through the ceiling and joins the fray and slashes all the obi stripes, ending the battle. Daki notices that her fragments return, having lost the fight in her hidden pantry against the many fighters. And with them back, Daki grows stronger, no longer split between two areas. She celebrates the fact that a Hashira has finally arrived and she can kill him to impress Muzan later. But some bystander interrupts her glee and she lashes out, slicing at him and the surrounding buildings. She cuts the man's arm off, injuring others, with pieces of the buildings collapsing down into the road. Leaving with a smile, Daki intends to find the Hashira, but Tanjiro interrupts her, and she tells him to be quiet since an ugly human's life has no value. But with more strength than she had previously seen, Daki gets pulled back by Tanjiro as he stops her on the roof. She startles but catches her footing easily. Now, words that sound familiar spill from Tanjiro's mouth, but Daki realizes that these are not her memories, but Muzan's of a past slayer with a marking on his face. Although Daki was once human, she doesn't care about that and says it's gone now. She can't grow old or sick or die or lose anything, so there is no reason for her to care about these human lives. Daki unleashes her blood demon art, 8-layered Obi Slash, to be rid of the Demon Slayer reminding her of the past. But her attack is not only stopped, it is countered and leaves her with wounds that won't heal and are burning. Tanjiro gets close enough to cut Daki's head, but the skin of her neck turns to the same stretchy fabric of her Obi and cannot be sliced so easily. With more strands of her Obi, Daki attacks Tanjiro and makes it difficult for him to dodge, but he pushes them all to one side, aiming for her neck once more. Luckily for Daki, he had been in a trance too long and finally collapses when his body reaches its limitations. Taking the chance to attack, Daki turns the tables but is stopped by Nezuko. Enraged by the damage she had received, Daki screams at Nezuko for her audacity. But as she does so, she recognizes Nezuko as a demon that Muzan told her about. Before Daki can be kicked again, she uses her Obi to slash Nezuko's leg from her body, overwhelming her easily. And just from how slow Nezuko's healing is, Daki can tell that she has never consumed human flesh and cannot compare to her in strength. But through sheer will, Nezuko is able to heal all her wounds, even the cutting in half that Daki had just done to her. And even more surprising, Nezuko, with no human blood, heals just as quickly as an upper rank demon. But Nezuko only kicks again, so Daki slices her leg off just as before. Nezuko's next attack is so much stronger that Daki is unable to cut her leg even for a shallow wound. Daki is slammed into the ground, pierced through the middle, with Nezuko's leg she had just sliced off. Daki struggles to free herself from the weight of Nezuko's attack, so she uses her Obi and slashes at her relentlessly, cutting off limbs, her head, and her entire body for that matter. But the pieces do not fall or disintegrate. Daki notices Nezuko's blood keeps the limbs connected. Daki gets splashed by the blood and it burns her flesh, with Nezuko then stomping on her while smiling cruelly. But as Nezuko gets distracted by humans nearby, Daki begins healing, much slower than usual, as this attack of Nezuko's only has an effect on demons. And I can only imagine that her prior experience of being burnt alive as a human only made this that much more insufferable for her. I mean, at this point, she is so furious and intent on revenge that she misses the arrival of Tengen, the Hashira she had been waiting for, and he cuts her head before she can even notice. With her head in her hands, literally, Daki bawls at having lost so easily, but she doesn't disappear as demons normally would. Tengen begins to insult her weakness, accusing her of not being an upper rank, which only upsets her more. And as she becomes inconsolable, Daki calls for her big brother Yutaro to help. Her brother appears from her back, helping Daki to put her head back on her shoulders. His touch is even able to soothe her wounds from the previous burns. Daki complains to Gyutaro about how she was bullied and fighting so hard, and so he promises to protect her and get them back. When Tengen tries to kill Gyutaro with his explosive power, Daki goes to his side, covering him in her thick Obi to protect him from the huge attack. Daki and Gyutaro team up, rushing at Tengen, but he kicks Daki into the air to stop her Obi. Daki loses her head again, too slow for Tengen's attack, but does not die. Tengen realizes that to kill Daki, he must slice her and her brother's head off at the same time, but she taunts him that it won't be so easy considering how much of the night is left. Zenitsu and Inosuke join to fight Daki, and she bristles at Zenitsu's words that she needs to apologize to the girl she had hurt as the Oiran. Daki then points out that those girls are objects to be sold and who can be bought and broken as someone pleases. And so she believes that those girls, not beautiful enough to make money, deserve to be mistreated if they cannot be of use, just as Daki was mistreated in the past. She intends to spread that misery until she is satisfied with how much she has done. As Daki finishes talking, an extra eye appears in the center of her forehead, releasing her full power with the help of her brother being in the fight with her. Her speed and attack power reach similar levels to her brother Gyutaro as he fights the Hashira, and her Obi slashes through the air with attack after attack. When her brother is backed in by Tengen, Daki's Obi appears to block those attacks as well. When Gyutaro goes after Hinatsuru, since she shot poison kunai at him, Daki blocks Tengen for getting in the way of her brother. He is stopped by Tanjiro using his water breathing style though. But as Zenitsu and Inosuke get desperate against Daki, she doesn't let up on her Obi attacks, making sure they can't get close enough to reach her neck. Daki laughs as the younger Demon Slayers start to lose steam, knowing that she is closer to victory than ever with the Hashira Tengen being poisoned. But as Daki gets overconfident, her attention splits between the three men, and she cannot defend against a rush by Inosuke as well as she did before. With the double swords, Daki's head goes flying for the third time, and Inosuke runs off with it so she cannot reattach it, before her brother's head also gets cut off. Gyutaro comes to Daki's rescue, stabbing Inosuke through the heart and taking his sister's head back. With all the slayers incapacitated, Daki's brother offers Tanjiro the chance to become a demon and protect his own younger sister. But Daki has a bad feeling about the offer and tells him not to do it. While he's distracted by a headbutt, Daki notices her brother has fallen to the ground because of a poisoned kunai in his leg. Daki screams in desperation as Tanjiro has his sword at her big brother's neck, but she tries to stop him. Then from out of the rubble, Zenitsu appears, trying to slice her neck off with his godlike speed, and Daki stretches her neck again with the Obi-like material to ensure it stays attached. While her brother struggles to keep the Hashira and Tanjiro back, he helps Daki to keep the younger slayer at bay because their sight is connected. As Daki boasts of her power and her brother's strength as well, she misses that Tanjiro has trapped Gyutaro and is slicing his head off. Daki has no time to react as her head is lobbed off her shoulders by Inosuke, who somehow recovers from being stabbed in the heart. Slash, at the same moment, Daki's head falls, facing her brothers on the ground with no one to save the other. Before having their heads severed from their necks, Daki and her brother got along very well. But now as they lay there dying in their final moments, they argue loudly and in a vicious way. Daki points the blame at her brother as he's the older one, and he points the blame at her considering he was fighting Tengen. When Daki is insulted for not being strong enough, she resorts to her usual insult about looks. She even goes as far as to accuse him of not being related to her. The insults only turn uglier and more brutal until Tanjiro steps in and stops the siblings. As Daki Head disappears, she calls out for her brother, wanting him by her side after all. Daki meets Gyutaro again in an in-between place, glad that they're back together. Her beautiful human form also returns, but Gyutaro only feels guilt for how their lives ended up, and so he pushes her away. This only saddens Daki, who thinks that she is the one at fault, begging for his forgiveness as he is the only family she has ever had. Before he can leave, Daki leaps onto her brother's back. She clings to him, tears falling from her eyes and desperate to never be separated from him again, even in their next lives. Finally, Gyutaro wraps his arms around her and carries Daki into the afterlife with him. Guys, I really love Daki and the demon sibling dynamic she possesses with her older brother Gyutaro. One that to an extent feels like it could have been a darker version of Tanjiro and Nezuko's story. The fact of the matter being that demon slayers appear only after demons have already brought about death and have been detected. In the case of Daki and her sibling, their tragedy was not caused by a demon, yet the one to come to their aid, similarly to how Gyu had for Tanjiro and Nezuko after their tragedy, was the upper rank 2 demon, Doma. And so who is to say that if placed in the very same predicament, Tanjiro wouldn't make a similar choice? And I really love when villains make you think like that. And I think that if you enjoyed the video, you should be sure to check out all the in-depth Demon Slayer content we have on the channel. And be sure to subscribe to Plot Armor with notifications on, because when it comes to bringing you some of the best Demon Slayer content on the platform, Plot Armor has you covered. As always, I'm Slice of Otaku. Thank you all so much for watching and have an awesome day. I love you.